Okay, welcome back to another video on kind of whatever's going through my head. So I really appreciate the comments and encouragement I've been getting on this video series. It's kind of a workout video. It's kind of like, whatever pops into my head about the river. So today I thought I would take some time to talk about how you need to be fit. I mean, yesterday's video was a little bit heavy, so I figured I'd talk about something a little bit more light, but still important about rafting and what you need to do. So my opinion on it is that rafting encompasses a lot of sports, as much as rafting. In a way, like, we're almost weightlifters in a way. We're paddlers, canyoneers, hikers. There's a lot that goes into it, you know? Sometimes you gotta walk to a put-in a little ways. We've been running a lot of Slab Creek in the South Fork of the American, and there's a pretty heinous walk down just to get to the river. I mean, it's really steep. You got a boat on your head, you're carrying it. It's a lot of weight you're dealing with. You got a bunch of gear that you're grappling with. So that's part of the sport, lifting boats, moving boats, rigging gear. It's not just the paddling or rowing, whatever you choose to do in a raft. Sometimes you have to scout. When you have to scout, okay, you pull over, and what do? You got to walk down the canyon. So that requires canyoneering skills, navigation skills, scouting skills, a whole slew of things, because sometimes, especially in the Sierras here, there are a lot of sheer granite domes that rise out of the river. So you don't have a lot of area to really walk in that's super safe. A lot of times you have real chossy rock, so you'll be walking on things like lichen and moss and tufts of grass. All those things get really slippery, so if you're on a really slippery slope, hey, you could take a tumble into the river. So knowing those skills on how to portage, how to walk around rocks, how to explore a canyon, those are all really important skills, I think. And so it requires a lot of different levels of fitness. One thing I like to tell people is, let's say you are two most of the time, I always try and talk about work out, prepare, train for what you do most of the time. So I R2 a lot, and usually I'm in a smaller boat, and the boats are usually anywhere between 70 and maybe 140 pounds. So based on that, I actually have to be able to pull my weight, my personal gear, half of the gear that we put in the boat, and half the boat. So when you're R2ing, think about that. I mean, I weigh about 185 right now. Throw in a bunch of wet personal gear, say another 20 pounds, 190, 205. And then we probably have, paddles are pretty heavy, 5 pounds maybe per paddle. We got four of them in the boat, one for me, one for my R2 partner, two spares. And then so when we have that in the boat, I mean, there's another 10 pounds, so that's 215. And like I said, maybe another 20 pounds of gear, so I'm pulling half of that, 225. So I need to be able to pull 225 pounds. If you can't do that, if you can't drag it, maybe you go to portage, right? What are you going to do with your boat? You got to move your boat around. Let's say, worst case scenario, I'm paddling with a guy my same size or even bigger. That guy gets injured, and we have to portage him around the rapid. Well, what now? Somebody's got to be able to carry that guy. So it's not only carrying that guy, but it's also carrying him through that river environment, carrying him through the canyon. Maybe you got to hike out with someone. That means someone of my size, that's a lot to carry out of there with personal gear and things like that. We got that 215 number, and then you got to tack on the raft as well. So that's going to add another 35 to 70 pounds. So let's just kind of round it off. Say, well, you should train for what you're going to do the most. So I typically have smaller boats. Add another 35 pounds on there. So we got 215. We're up to 250. So I got to be able to drag 250 pounds pretty much all the time. At a moment's notice, and these are rough numbers, of course, but it's a good thing to think about, like, how much do you have to carry? Also, if you take a swim, You know, I've seen trips recently, people have taken 2, 3, 4 swims in a trip. Well, if you take 3 or 4 swims, you got to be able to pull yourself back in the boat. So that means all that gear plus when you're tired. So if you can't, say, do this workout that I'm doing right now and then go and do pull-ups with more weight on you, well, it's going to be tough to pull yourself in the boat. You're going to be spending time swimming to shore. And that's another good skill, too. That I think about it, when you swim, got to be a good swimmer. So if you have access to a pool, I encourage you guys to add a pool part of your workout. Maybe once, twice a week if you have time. Go to the pool, swim out, you know, a bunch of laps. Most rivers are pretty small. You're not going to spend a half mile swimming, but if you can swim a half mile uninterrupted, then that's great. Even if you'll have a PFD on when you swim in the river, but it's always good to train without one. So I just really want you guys to think about the situations that you're going to be in. There's a lot of training that goes into it. I was talking to Daniel yesterday, and we're discussing, hey, what are all the skills that people need for rafting? You know, there's a lot of skills. Like I said, hiking, canyoneering, swimming, weightlifting, just in rafting itself. So, you know, as a raft guide, you kind of have to be all-around good athlete. It's not just, hey, I'm a great raft guide. Well, sure, you can guide a raft, but can you hike that raft out if there's a problem? One of the main complaints I have about one of my boats is that there's only 2 tubes, okay? So I rip a tube. Say it's a long rip and I don't have enough material to patch it. Well, guess what? I'm hiking out. I have to hike that boat, which I've done before. I've had bad swims and bad times where I ended up hiking the boat out. I got to throw the 67 pounds of my little boat on my back, plus my personal gear, hike out. Now what? So if you guys can't do that, I encourage you, load up the backpack, start hiking, start swimming, start weightlifting, start doing a lot of different exercises, and you'll find that your body shape kind of reflects what you do most of the time, but you'll also find that I think a lot of guides have a very balanced kind of body shape. I used to surf a lot. I lived in Santa Cruz for a while, and when I did, my body was like an upside down triangle. My legs were all thin and skinny, and I wasn't running a lot, but my upper body was just massive and built. And I lost a bunch of that muscle mass and started boating again after I left Santa Cruz. And my muscle mass evened out. So it went from this big upside-down triangle to more of like a good all-around muscle mass. So just because you're a big guy doesn't mean you're necessarily better at doing it. If you're, let's say you're a small girl and you're like maybe 100 pounds soaking wet, well, there's nothing wrong with that. In terms of boating, as long as you can pull yourself. You can pull yourself, you can operate in a canyon environment. You may be actually better at guiding and better at boating all around than the guy who, say, can bench 400 pounds, but he can't move his neck more than this. If that's the case, if you're an all-around better swimmer, you're a better canyoneer, you're a better hiker, you're a better paddler, I mean, who cares? Yeah, that guy can pull a truck, but that doesn't mean that he's going to be great at boating. It doesn't mean he's going to be great in this all-around environment. So I encourage you guys to cross-train with multiple sports, multiple different training regimens, not just one sort of thing. I felt that I needed to get into a better paddling rhythm, so I put this out there. And hope you guys will keep following along. And again, I appreciate the encouragement. So if you like what you see, if you're enjoying the content, please make sure you like this video and subscribe and make sure you find out more content from us. We got some great, great paddling technique videos coming up here pretty soon. We're going to be doing some interviews, and we're really looking forward to a lot of the new stuff we're going to be putting out in 2018. So thanks for following along, and we'll see you guys downriver.